Today we're taking a look at how you can go about installing or reinstalling the Microsoft Store on your computer if it's missing for some reason, or maybe you're using an IoT Enterprise LTSC version of Windows, or even a modified version of Windows, like the unattended WinStall version of Windows that I've made that also does not come with the Microsoft Store installed on it. Now in this video, I'm going to be showing you two methods that you can use to install or reinstall the Microsoft Store, and both of these methods work on Windows 10 and Windows 11. I'm going to be using both Windows 10 and Windows 11 in this video to show you how you can install the Microsoft Store. So let's start with the easy way to install the Microsoft Store, and I'm going to be showcasing this on the IoT Enterprise LTSC version of Windows. So inside of Windows 10 and Windows 11, if we go to the File Explorer here and we navigate to the Windows folder on the C drive, there's going to be this folder called WinSXS. And if we do a search inside of this folder for wsreset, you'll find a folder with an application inside of it called wsreset. Now, just double clicking this does nothing. It's not going to open the Microsoft Store or anything. But if we have a look at the description of this application and we go to properties, you can see that this tool resets the Windows Store without changing account settings or deleting installed apps. So the way that you go about using this is actually through PowerShell, and you can launch that by right-clicking on the Start button, then opening Windows PowerShell as admin, then just accept any prompts that you might have. And then also very important, make sure that you are connected to the internet before doing this, because otherwise it can't download the Microsoft Store. So the command that you're going to type here is wsreset --i. So we're targeting this wsreset application. So once you've typed that exactly like that, you can just press enter to run the command. You're not going to see any output. It's just going to show you a new line that you can start typing on. But what you need to do now is just wait a few minutes. You can see the time down there. So in a few minutes time, the Microsoft Store is just going to appear in the start menu here, and I'll be able to use it. So let's speed up the video and see how long it takes. So it didn't even take a minute, and the store just got installed. I even got a notification about it, and it also appeared in the start menu here. So if I go ahead and click on the Microsoft Store to launch it, you can see that it is working flawlessly. I can use it to install apps, and this is still on the IoT Enterprise LTSC version of Windows. And like I said before, this works on Windows 10 and Windows 11. So that's going to be by far the easiest way to reset or reinstall the Microsoft Store and get it working on your computer. Now for the second method, in case the wsreset method doesn't work for you, I'm going to be showcasing this on Windows 11 24H2, and I installed this using my unattended WinStall answer file. And as you can see, the wsreset executable is also found on Windows 11, so I can use the same method as before to install the Microsoft Store on here. But for the purposes of this video, I want to show you the second method as well. So the second method is using the Xbox app for Windows to install the Microsoft Store. So you can just do a search on Google for Xbox app for Windows. I'm just going to click on the Xbox app for Windows PC download link here. And then once you're on this Microsoft webpage, you can just find the download link, and you can see there is some system requirements for this. So you do need at least 19H1 or higher to use this app. But you can download the app from the webpage here, which will download the Xbox installer. Then you can open the file and you can just install the Xbox app for Windows. You can accept the terms, click on install, and then it's going to start installing. Then you can just wait for this to finish installing. Then once it's finished, you can just finish the installation, and it's going to open the Xbox app on PC. Then you can sign in with a Microsoft account if you want, or you can just click on browse the catalog. You can change these settings to your preferences, but as soon as it's launched, you'll see that there's missing components for the Xbox app and that you can review them. But to get to the missing components as well, you can just click on the profile icon up here, then you can go to settings and then go to app, and you'll see that there's missing dependencies on this computer. Now you can see that the Microsoft Store is one of them, but there are some others that's also missing, and you can install all of them if you want. But if you only want the Microsoft Store, you can just click on install. You'll obviously just have to wait for it to finish as well, but once it's finished installing, it'll disappear from this list. And if you go to your start menu and go to all apps, you'll see that you now have the Microsoft Store installed. And if you open that, you can start using it, and it works perfectly fine. Now, a few things I'll mention is some people have reported a lot of issues that they can't get the Xbox app for Windows installed on their computer. I'm not sure exactly why that happens, but if you can't get the Xbox app for Windows installed using the method that I just showed you, I do want to show you another method by using WinGet, and you can actually do this in two ways. The first way is you can get this package ID from the Xbox App Microsoft Store link. And this is going to work best on Windows 11 because Windows 11 already has WinGet pre-installed. On Windows 10, it doesn't work that well because WinGet has to be installed first. But I am going to showcase this on Windows 11 here. So if I right-click on the Start button and then open Windows PowerShell as admin, if I type the following command, which is going to be winget.exe space install space dash dash ID, and I then go ahead and copy this package ID from the Microsoft Store. So everything after the forward slash, but before the question mark. If I copy that package ID and I go back to PowerShell and I then right click to paste it, and I just put this in quotes like that, and I press enter, it should use WinGet to install or update the Xbox app for Windows. So you see that I have to accept the source agreements, and I'm just going to press Y and then enter to accept those. And there is a command that you can use to skip the source agreements, but to keep it simple, that is the command that you can use. So you can see that it's found an existing package already installed because obviously I already installed the Xbox app for Windows, and it tried to upgrade it or update it to the latest version, but it couldn't do that because I already have the latest version installed. So you can try and use this command in the event that you couldn't get the Xbox app for Windows PC installed using the normal installer. And if this method didn't work for you, then I recommend you try and use UniGet UI. And then in the Discover Packages tab, you do a search for Xbox. You find Xbox on this list here, and then you try and install it through UniGet UI. This is going to do the exact same thing as installing it with WinGet. As you can see, it's just going to run this command here, which is also going to install it by using that package ID. But maybe you have a better chance of getting the Xbox app for Windows installed using UniGet UI than trying to do it yourself with the command line. But those are the two methods that you can use to install or reinstall a missing Microsoft Store on Windows 10 and Windows 11. But with all of that being said, I really hope this video was useful to you. If it was, please give it a like. And I also want to give a shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thank you so much for supporting my channel. I really appreciate it. And if you've never seen UniGet UI before, I recommend checking out the video that I'm going to leave at the end of this video for a full breakdown of this software, because in my opinion, it really is the best free software manager that you can get for Windows. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.